Hello, you gorgeous, lovely people. This is Chris from Recombo, and I'm here with the shiny new OnePlus 5T, freshly launched at the end of 2017. I'm going to do a quick side-by-side with the Nokia 8, which has actually come down in price quite a lot since launch. It's now just £399 SIM-free here in the UK, which means it's even cheaper than the £449 OnePlus 5T. Starts at 449, goes up to 499. Well, first of all, in terms of the dimensions, they're more or less the same. Unfortunately, that's because they've got quite thick bezels on the Nokia 8 above and below the display. So it's actually only a 5.3-inch screen compared with a 6-inch panel on the OnePlus 5T, which of course manages to fill that space quite nicely with very narrow top and bottom bezels instead. If we flip around to the back of both of these blowers, you'll see that it's a very different design around the back as well. You get this nice shiny glossy finish on the Nokia 8. It does pick up fingerprints quite easily, gets a little bit smeary at times, and it does have a couple of little scratches on it after a few months of use, but overall it's holding up quite nicely. We love this copper finish, it looks really, really nice, very unique. As you can see on the OnePlus, it's more of a traditional matte metallic finish. It's reasonably plain. As you can see, a little bit of branding on both handsets. And of course, you don't have to worry about fingerprint grease or anything. A couple of little light scratches after very little use, so you'll want to protect it. Luckily, you do get a rubber case in the actual box, so that's all good. As you can see, ever so slightly jutting camera lens as well in the case of the OnePlus 5T, whereas it's almost flush with the surface on the Nokia. Water resistance, you don't get any kind of water resistance on the OnePlus 5T, although it'll function fine in rain and the rest of it. With the Nokia, it's actually IP54 splash proof, so you can give it a good bit of splashing, get it nice and moist, and it should still function absolutely fine, although you should probably best off not taking it into the shower or anything just in case. Thankfully, both phones do come with a headphone jack as well. It's up top on the Nokia 8, whereas it's right there on the bottom in the case of the OnePlus. And they both sport a nice bit of Type-C USB charging, which is always good, and bottom-mounted speakers as well. As you can see, of course, because you've got that big, thick bezel beneath the screen on the Nokia, you can, of course, get your fingerprint sensor action on the go there. It's a really narrow scanner, so it's quite difficult to see, but it's still impressively accurate. Just tap your thumb to it, and it just opens up straight away. On the case of the OnePlus, it is, of course, mounted around the back because there's no space beneath the screen. And again, it's nice and responsive. Your finger falls naturally on it when you pick up the device, and it's a quick tap and you're straight in again. But it's also got Face ID facial recognition. So around the front, the sensor can actually pick up your face. It makes a full 3D map of it. And if you're, in case you're wearing gloves or your hands are a bit mucky or something, the fingerprint sensor is out of bounds, just put your face up to it, give it a quick tap, and you're straight into your desktop's lovely stuff. As for that screen tech, well, as we said before, the OnePlus 5T sports the more spacious screen. It's a 6-inch compared with a 5.3. It's also an AMOLED panel compared with an IPS on the Nokia. So that means it does draw a bit more power, unfortunately, but you can also get nice sharp contrast and quite punchy visuals as well. They're reasonably punchy on the Nokia as well, to be fair. We're perfectly happy with that display, despite the fact that it isn't quite as spacious as the OnePlus's. And of course, you get this lovely 18:9 aspect ratio on the OnePlus compared with the more traditional 16:9 on the Nokia. So that means this is better suited to the likes of Netflix, things like that, whenever you get that on the go. A lot of apps are starting to adapt to the 18:9 aspect ratio as well. But of course, the Nokia will fully support any apps that you've got out there. One advantage that Nokia does have in terms of the display tech is the fact that it's a Quad HD panel. So if we just drag up here, just get a little bit closer, you'll see you'll certainly struggle to notice any kind of individual pixels on the Nokia. That said, the OnePlus 5T, despite the fact that it's a full HD panel, you'll still struggle as well. It's still nice and crisp, and you do get great viewing angles on both of these handsets as well. So certainly no complaints as far as the display tech goes. Now, the Nokia has just actually entered beta for Android Oreo, which is the latest version of Google's mobile OS. Unfortunately, we've still got Nougat on the OnePlus 5T as well. That should get full update in the new year to Android Oreo as well. And it's a pretty raw version of Android on the Nokia. As you can see, it's just basically as Google intended, pretty much, with all of their usual features. In the case of the OnePlus 5T, you get Oxygen OS on top of it. So that's still a pretty traditional Android layout, but you do get some bonus stuff in there, such as the shelf, which you can flick to, which basically just allows you to chuck a bunch of widgets on there. So you've got fast access to your calendar, your favorite apps, your favorite contacts, and all the rest of it. You can also customize the desktop a little bit more thoroughly, so choose the grid layout, all that kind of stuff. And if we dive into the settings, you get some bonus modes tucked away in here as well. So for instance, more gesture support. So for instance, you can take a screenshot nice and easily, flip to mute. You can draw a letter in order to open up a certain app on the screen from the lock screen. You've also got some stuff down here in advanced to game and do not disturb mode, things like that. So a few extra little bonus features thrown in there, which are actually quite nice. And of course, because it's a bigger phone, you'll probably need a little bit of one-handed use every now and then, which definitely need a little bit of assistance. So in the case of the OnePlus 5T, you can drag down the notifications bar from anywhere on the screen, which is definitely a good little feature to have. So what's actually running the show? Well, in both cases, it is Qualcomm Snapdragon 835. In the case of the Nokia, that's backed by 4 gigs of RAM, which is certainly does the job. As you can see, it's nice and nippy still, as you'd expect. It's only just launched and it is rocking that premium flagship device. So there you go, no problems whatsoever. You can load up apps in an instant, they're just straight into it, perfect. So no problems whatsoever. It's exactly the same on the OnePlus. It's actually got more RAM, it's a minimum of 6. You can get up to 8 gigabytes as well if you pick the Midnight Black model, which is what this one is. And it's definitely just as nippy with its Snapdragon 835 chipset. As you can see, apps once again load instantly, no hanging around at all. As for the storage space, you get plenty in both cases. You get a minimum of 64 gigabytes, no matter which model you choose. In the case of the OnePlus 5T, it's either 64 gigs or 128. You get plenty of space, therefore, for all of your apps and media and all the rest. Sadly, you can't expand via micro SD on the OnePlus 5T, whereas you can on the Nokia 8. And you can also get up to 256 gigs of storage on this bad boy as well. As for the battery tech, we jump back out. It's a 3,300 milliamp battery on the OnePlus 5T. As you can see, pretty bug standard battery saver mode and all the rest of it. Battery on this bad boy is a 30,090 milliamp cell. And in case of the Nokia, we get pretty good battery life, about a day and a half per charge. The OnePlus 5T is maybe just over a day with pretty heavy use, although a bit more time. We've only had it for a couple of days, so see how it lasts. It will hopefully improve over time. So stay tuned for our in-depth review for more on that. And of course, you get a bit of quick charge support on the Nokia Quick Charge 3.0, which is Qualcomm's own design. So it charges back up to close to full in just an hour and gives you a good couple of hours of use for just 10 minutes of the plug. In the case of the OnePlus 5T, its dash charge is more than a match. However, again, an hour at the plug, it'll almost be full and you'll get a solid couple of hours of use from just 10 minutes of charging. Which brings us onto the camera tech. So, as you can see, of course, both of these phones sport a bit of dual lens camera action. In the case of the Nokia, you get a 13 megapixel primary lens backed by a secondary 13 megapixel, again, lens with a bit of optical image stabilization built in, and it's an f2.0 aperture as well. So reasonably good in low light. Does pretty good photos and videos overall. You can shoot up to 4K video. And if we just take a quick look at the camera interface, it's pretty straightforward stuff. Nice swift shutter action as well. Even though it's quite low light in this area, quite tricky light for the studio, it actually does pretty well. And as you can see, of course, you get various effects. You can take a bothy, for instance, if you tap there, which uses both the front and the rear camera to take a shot. Pretty pointless, but there you go. It's there if you want it. And of course, you can choose to use either the color lens or the mono lens or both at once, depending on what kind of effect you want. And of course, you get a good few camera modes to play around with. You can, of course, shoot up to 4K resolution video. You get full manual controls if you want to fiddle around with the likes of white balance, ISO levels, all that kind of stuff. You get the live bokeh mode, which can add a nice background blur effect to your photos using the dual lens camera setup. Of course, you get panorama mode and you get the typical beautify mode, which just irons out some of those wrinkles and creases and the rest. So you get a good few bonus modes there. And if we switch to video modes, you'll see that, of course, you get slow motion and time lapse there, though no manual controls, of course. And you can, of course, stream your video live to Facebook or YouTube as well via the live feature. Meanwhile, if we jump into the OnePlus 5T's camera app, you can see it's a very similar sort of setup. Again, just take a quick shot using the shutter button. It seems like a really nippy shutter. Definitely happy with that. If you drag this out, you can play around with the likes of the HDR functionality and the various other settings. And if you drag the other way, you've got, again, a handful of bonus camera modes. You can, again, shoot up to 4K resolution video. You, again, have time-lapse and slow motion, and, of course, full manual controls if you need them. There's no bothy mode, unfortunately. And you can also you can't stream live to Facebook or YouTube via the camera app. But otherwise, does all the stuff that you would expect. And around the front, you also get a 16 megapixel f2.0 aperture lens, whereas you get a 13 megapixel on the Nokia. So that in a nutshell is the brand new shiny OnePlus 5T versus the Nokia 8. Nokia 8, actually quite an enticing prospect now that it's come down in price. That was always our major bugbear with that handset when it first launched. Of course, the OnePlus 5T does offer that slicker design, the bigger screen, and it's got a few extra bonus features such as the Face ID. So which one might you be tempted to buy? Let us know in the comments below. It'll be really interesting to hear what you think. And thanks for watching, everyone. Stay tuned for our in-depth OnePlus 5T review and camera review. And of course, check out all of our other comparisons. Thanks for watching. Bye.